welcome back to my channel. Today I will be making one of my favorite shrimp recipes, and as always, don't forget all the ingredients will be listed down below. So in case you miss anything, all the ingredients will be listed down below, and I'll do my best to also put the ingredients on the screen. But in this recipe, I'm going to be making shrimp with potatoes and like a gravy sauce with the shrimp. Since I'm using frozen shrimp, the first thing I do is I go ahead and defrost the shrimp. I do that by just letting it sit in some room temperature to lukewarm water for a little bit, and then I rinse it out and I just make sure the shrimp is nice and clean and prepared to be cooked. Now that the shrimp has been cleaned and dried off, I'm gonna go ahead and start with the seasoning. I'm doing my best job to always put the picture of the seasoning right along the screen, so in case you guys do wanna go out to the store and buy the same things, you know exactly what it looks like rather than just listing all the ingredients at the bottom. So I hope you guys find this helpful. If there's something more you guys need me to do, just let me know. But now I've seasoned the shrimp, I'm just gonna go ahead and mix everything together. Once the shrimp is all mixed together, I usually let it rest for about 5 to 15 minutes just to let the seasoning marinate into the shrimp itself. Now I'm going ahead and adding oil and garlic to the pot and just letting that fry up for a little bit, but not too much because you don't want the garlic to burn. But once the oil is nice and hot, I'm going to go ahead and add my shrimp into the pot and let it cook for a little bit. And just a reminder that shrimp does cook pretty fast, especially if you have the heat on high. So you want to make sure you keep an eye on it. Once it starts to turn like pinkish as this one, you want to flip them just to make sure that each side is getting cooked evenly. And I just like to keep flipping them because I want my shrimp to be done as fast as possible, but also cooked as evenly as possible. Once the shrimp is cooked, I usually just put it aside. I take it out the pot, I put it in a new clean bowl and let that rest for a little while. Go ahead and make the sauce within the same pan that we just took the shrimp out of. So right now I'm just adding butter to just the sauce that was left over from the shrimp. And this way it's gonna be nice and buttery and just like sweet and delicious. Trust me, you don't wanna like skip adding butter to this. But I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit more garlic and all the rest of the ingredients, as I said, I will always listed on the bottom of the screen the best of my ability, but I love a nice garlicky sauce, and garlic kind of thickens the sauce a little bit, and honestly just the taste of garlic is unmatched in my opinion. I'm gonna go ahead and add some heavy cream right now to the recipe, and also some dry white wine. These were local store brands that I used for the cream and the white wine, so you guys can always go ahead and just substitute it for whatever you guys have in your store. Just a heavy cream that's made for cooking, you can usually find that around the milk section, and then any dry white wine, like I said, I'm using Sauvignon Blanc here. I'm gonna go ahead and add some red onions because I also just love red onions, especially in any type of sauce. You will probably always see me add a little bit of onion. I absolutely love it. And yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and let all these cook. I want to make sure I stir the sauce occasionally just to, number one, check the consistency to see if it's thickened any bit, and just to make sure it's also not getting stuck to the bottom of the pot because I do want this to be saucy and creamy. We'll be right back. Now that the sauce is boiling again and it's nice and cooked, I'm gonna go ahead and add some Parmesan cheese to the sauce. I love a good cheesy sauce. Again, I'm just making the sauce off the fly with just ingredients that I already had at home. I just needed something to go along with the shrimp and the potatoes that I'm making alongside this. I'm also adding some arugula to the sauce. I just like to add some greens to it. Usually whatever greens I have on hand, again, spinach, kale, or arugula will do just fine. It gives it color and it adds a little bit of nutritional benefits to your sauce as well. Again, I was going for like a gravy consistency because I do want to serve this with whipped potatoes, as I keep saying, and honestly, I was just loving how the sauce was coming out. It's just giving exactly what I wanted it to give, and I just knew at this point that this was going to taste delicious and look delicious. Now that the sauce is ready, I'm just going to go ahead and add the shrimp right back into it and just let it sit and rest within the sauce for a little bit while I finish up with the whipped potatoes. I am making the whipped potatoes alongside with this, and I did record that recipe as well. I will be sharing that in a separate video coming up next on my channel. So if you're not subscribed, just make sure you hit the subscribe button and try and follow along on this cooking YouTube journey channel with me. I'm really just trying to like share recipes that I make quickly at home, especially when I'm like trying to fight the urge to order takeout. So this is why I made this channel. I really just want to like keep reminding myself that there's food at home, we can cook something at home, and takeout is not always the answer because not every meal takes a long time. Like a lot of these meals take me like under 30 minutes to cook, and they're easy, they're delicious, and the whole family can eat it. This is how the shrimp looks like when it's completely ready and prepared. The gravy just looks so good. The shrimp looks amazing, and trust me guys, it tasted way better than it even looks. So this is how I served it on the plate. I just served it alongside the whipped potatoes. I put the gravy over the shrimp and I just ate them together, and oh my gosh, this was one of the best meals I've had in such a long time, and it took me literally under 30 minutes to make everything from start to finish. So if you're interested in more recipes like this, then please just make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. And if you try out this recipe, leave me a comment down below and let me know how it came out for you. Thank you for watching my video, and I'll see you in the next one.